Hello everyone, I am Supheri from sansupheri.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn COUNTIF function in Excel. COUNTIF function is used to count the number of cells in a range that match the supplied criteria and return the result as a number representing cells counted. Let's start by going to Excel. Here is the syntax for COUNTIF function in Excel. There are two criteria, range and criteria. Here is the COUNTIF function in Excel. There are two arguments in COUNTIF function. The first argument is range. The second argument is criteria. Range is the range of cells to count. The criteria that control which cells should be counted. I have a table cell that we want to use the COUNTIF function in Excel to count with the criteria that we want. Here's the example that we want to use COUNTIF. The first example, I want to count cell over $100 based on this table. So let's start with the COUNTIF formula, equal sign, type COUNTIF, range. The range that I want to count is on this cell. Here's the range, comma, and the criteria. The criteria, I want to count the cell over $100. So I use the greater than sign and $100 with the bold quote. Close parenthesis and press enter to get the result. So the result is 3. Let's verify. More than $100, 1, 2, and 3. Yes, correct. Move to the next question. Count of cell by cell representative name Levite. Equal. Count if. In range. So let's select the range. So I want to count the cell representative. So my range is here on column cell representative. Here is my range, comma, and criteria. I use double quote for non-numerical characters. So I type Levi, close double quote. Close parenthesis and press enter to see the result. 2. Yes, correct. Verify. 1, 2. Move to the third question. Count of cell in bottom row. Equal sign. Count if. Range. At this time, my range that I want to count is Pravin column. So I select the range that I want to count, comma, and then my criteria is bottom row. Close parenthesis and press enter. 2. Let's verify. 1, 2. Correct. I want to show you the different criteria that we can use in COUNTIF. Please note that for non-numeric criteria, needs to be enclosed in the double quotes, but numeric criteria does not, like I have shown you for the previous example. So here is the different criteria for COUNTIF. For the first example, we want to count cell equal to 200. So you don't need the double quote for the example because it is numeric. For the second example, you use the double quote because it includes the greater than sign or less than sign. It consider it is not numeric character, it is a non-numeric character, so we have to use the double quote. This example, we want to count cell greater than 50. For the third example, we want to count the cell range A1 to A5 with the criteria superi. Count the cell equal to superi. And the last example, we can reference the COUNTIF criteria by reference from another cell. In this case, count cell less than value in B1. Let's see the example. The three examples above I have shown you already. So the last one, I'm going to show you the last one that reference value from another cell as a criteria. Let's start from here. Equal sign, count if, range. So the question count of cell over value based on value on cell G16. Here is the value of cell G16. So the range is, my range is here, comma, and then I use the greater than sign and use and sign to connect with the criteria reference cell. So in this case, my reference cell is G16, and close parenthesis and press enter. So in this case, the formula will look for the criteria on cell G16 here, 100. So we will count the cell over 100. So the count result is 3. Let's verify the value is more than 100. 1, 2, 3. If I change the value here, like more than 250, so the result here change to 1, because only one cell that has value more than 150. Let's verify from here to here. We found that only one cell is here, 200, is more than 150. Let's move on. Beyond the simple criteria, you also can use wildcard in criteria. The question mark criteria is used to match any one character. The asterisk is used to match any sequence of characters. To find a literal question mark or asterisk, we have to use a tile in front of the question mark or asterisk. It is a tile sign. Maybe some people difficult to find the tile sign on the keyboard. I just want to let you know where it is. So you can use the shift key and press the key on the left side of the same row of number 1. So you will get the sign tile. So let me give you the example how to use COUNTIF with the wildcard in criteria. So let's see the example. The question, count cell that end with asterisk sign. If you go through here, we will know that there is only one record that end with asterisk. Let's see the first example, count cell that end with asterisk. Equal sign, COUNTIF, range, comma, and criteria. So I don't care the beginning of character, so I use asterisk because asterisk match any sequence of characters. But at the end, I want to find or I want to count the cell that end with asterisk. So remember, we need to use the tile sign and then we need to use asterisk. Why we need to use a tile sign? Because if you want to find a special character like question mark or asterisk, we have to put a tile sign in front of asterisk or question mark. And also don't forget the bold quote, because it is not numeric character, so we have to use the bold quote. Close parenthesis and press enter. So the result is 1. Yes, only one. Let's count the cell that end with question mark. The same thing, count if, range, comma, double quote, anything in front of, a tile sign, and question mark, double quote, and close parenthesis and press enter. Only one. Yes, here only one. So I want to test that if I modify this record and by putting the question mark. So let's see how the result change here. Press enter. You will see the result change to 2. Okay. Go back. Let's answer the third question. Count cell that end with SR. So count if range, comma, and the criteria. We don't care for any character in front, but we care about the end of character SR, close parenthesis, and 2. Let verify. 1, 2, correct. Count cell that end with S. Range. Criteria. With S. Okay. The last question, count cell that has 5 character. Count if range criteria double quote 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I use 5 question mark because the question mark is used to match any one character. So in this question, we want to count cells that has 5 characters. Close parenthesis and press enter. We get 1. Okay. Let's test by modify this record. We will see. Move to 2. Yes, correct. Count is very important also to solve your problem at work. So you have to know more formula in Excel and combine with other formula to make the result more useful. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more upcoming video. Thank you.